Hi, welcome to This Week in Property. I'm Jayashree Kurup. I'm editor MBTV. I have with me Prabhakar Sinha. He's the real estate editor of the Times of India. We're talking about good. For me, fund finally seems to have taken off. There seems to be about 8,000 and odd crores that the government has announced it will be giving out. So today we're talking about the Swami Fund. Will construction start and delayed projects move forward? Joining us in this discussion is Rohit Raj Modi. He's the chief patron of the CREDAI Youth Wing and Women's Wing, and he's also part of the Ashiana Group. There's Jyoti Prakash Gadia. He's Managing Director of Resurgent India. Thank you so much for joining us, both of you. Rohit has also been at national levels. He has held CREDAI portfolios, and he has been a mover and shaker of the industry for the last couple of decades. So let's go to Rohit first. And Rohit, this Swami Fund, the last mile funding, the 25,000 crores alternate investment fund that the government of India had announced. It was probably announced late last year. Then by the time it was sorted out, we went into lockdown. Now, do you think that the fund will have a momentum of its own? And how long before the disbursements start?
No, I think it's one of the most interesting innovation which has happened in Indian real estate. A very positive out-of-the-box thinking by the government to solve the problem for a lot of stuck middle and affordable housing projects. It was first announced in September 2019 by the Honorable Finance Minister, and it got its legs probably around December 2019 and started to invite applications. But, you know, as we all know, that soon from middle of the Feb onwards, things started to slow down with COVID and finally into a lockdown. The fund has gained a lot of popularity. And I think post reduction in the rate of interest, it's gained a lot more interest from people. I think it's a fantastic move. Right now, probably it's funded to the extent of about 10,500 crores or 25,000 crores. But as it's a stated mandate, the government intends to make it many folds from its 25,000 onwards. I think the fund is being managed very well by SBI Venture Caps. A very professional team. You know, I can cite my own example, personal example over here. We have one project, which was probably the first one to jump on this opportunity, and we applied to them in November. And I remember sending the application myself from my mailbox on a Saturday evening at 7 o'clock, and I left office. And at 7:20, I had a proper acknowledgement back from Swami in my mailbox. I haven't seen that kind of promptness even by, you know, private sector banks or leading private equities, you know. And since then, our experience with them has been very, very professional. There are issues about it. We can come to that later as we go into the discussion.
Yeah. Prabhakar, you want to join in here?
Yeah, I mean, this is a great move that this fund was created, and particularly today, the real estate sector is really badly affected, and mainly due to this stalled projects or the delayed projects. And so there was a very high expectation from this funds, but unfortunately, because of certain provisions, the funds could not be released soon, and it has taken its own time. And even today, the 81 projects have been approved, and only 18 have been given funds, and with 8,000 crores. So that means the huge backlog is still there. And as this timeline is getting delayed, this impact will be increasing, and the problem will getting compounded day by day. So I believe that either the government should try to streamline the entire procedure so that fund could be real, allocation could start fast, fund could be released fast, or otherwise, I mean, many of the projects, just because of the delay of 6 months or 1 year, the project will never be able to come off. So taking this in mind, that's what I want to understand with Mr. Rohit Modi and Mr. Jyoti Gadia, that what should be done? Where is the problem? Why it is not happening?
So Jyoti Prakash, I would like you to actually make your opening comments, explaining how this fund is going to work. And now that we, like Prabhakar said, 81 projects are supposed to get it. 18 projects have, the funds have been released. What is the process of management here?
Thank you, Jayashree ma'am, for inviting me all here. Just to give you the my perspective of this fund to come back, and why this is so stringent, and why the process is taking so much of time and everything. need to understand real estate industry, there is a lot of legal complications. There are a lot of things that need to be clearly sorted out before even we go and talk about the giving the fund, to have the clarity about the project in terms of understanding that how much sale it has happened. To understand that also, it takes a lot of time for any of the player to come in and understand. And then about the land papers, understanding the title deeds and other things, which are not so much streamlined in India as on date. And regarding why it is taking so much of time and so much of stringency, we need to understand that fund, when it started operational in the month of November and till date, approximately around 4 or 5 important criteria points that they have laid down at the starting, and now they have come out with a lot of relaxations. Now they are also learning on the way. It is like on the job training that they are also doing it. Like the GST, if you talk about that, there were amendments coming up every month or so. So I could remember that in the month of November, when the fund came out, there were 2-3 stringent restrictions. The fund cannot be utilized for any part of the fund, cannot go for the, so for the land payments also. The rate of interest was also that much there. So there, and plus there will not be any sort of money that can go to the existing lender. So they will have a priority charge, and till the time their entire loan is being repaid, none of the money will go to the existing lender. I think there is a little bit of dilution right now in terms of all the clauses that for the land, if it comprises that it is an essential part of the payment or the project cannot be completed in case if you don't give the land payment, now they have started considering that land payment. Regarding the existing lender repayment also, they are seeing that after my repayment and after my everything, if the cash flow of the company is good enough for that, then they have started giving at least the interest portion of the existing lender. Although the priority charge clause has not been diluted, rate of interest clause, thanks to Rohit ji and other for all the CREDAI and the NAREDCO thing, I suppose the rate of interest they have drastically reduced from 300 basis point. That's a good rate of interest reduction as far as the fund house is concerned. Mm-hmm. Now, regarding the stringency, it is basically demand supply gap, Jayasri ma'am. Aap ichi samajhiye ki 5 lakh crore ki demand hai. There is a 5 lakh crore which is absolutely required in this sector, and they are only having 25,000 crore ka ek fund hai. So there is, you can see the amount of lining up which is there. So they are a pampered lot as on date. So they are Google, say, going to pick up the best among whatever is available to them. Aaj, we as financial advisory firm, I think we have put in around 62 applications to them. And with all the 62 applications all over India, we understand what sort of restrictions are there. Although in their charter, they have mentioned ki NCLT projects or NCLT, they are going to look into it. But the amount of work that they have, they are saying that NCLT project, we will look it at after we exhaust whatever the projects which are not under NCLT. Pehle hum un projects ko dekh lete hain jo NCLT mein nahi hai. So this is how the evolution is taking place. So do you want me to run through the entire fund scheme, or I suppose that is not required, but these are some of the issues which we can discuss while on the course of discussion about our practical experiences in filing the documents, or what are the practical difficulties that we are facing, how we can overcome with slight here and there. Those are the points that we can discuss while during the discussion. Yes, ma'am.
Rohit, when a large number of developers have applied, like Jyoti Prakash has said, what are the criteria that they are applying? Do you as a CREDAI member know this?
Yeah, of course. As I said, that I was the first one to get sanctioned, actually. I would actually differ a little here. You know, their criteria are not very stringent. They have a fairly liberal criteria, according to me. I won't find another lender in this country who would abide by criteria that they are going with, because we have to understand it's a benevolent fund. I mean, not meant to be, you know, just distributed as a largesse, but it's a benevolent fund because it's coming with a mandate, a social mandate to help get the projects completed, deliver the homes to the home buyers. So when they say that the project must be net worth positive, they are only seeing that is the receivable of the project more than the balance cost to completion, and can it cover the interest of Swami fund? They are not seeing whether below Swami, if there are existing lenders, whether they are getting covered, not getting covered. So in that sense, I would say it's a very liberally designed fund with the sole objective of helping the home buyers get their homes. Now, Jayashree, where is the problem? I'll just correct a couple of the figures, and as Honorable Finance Minister mentioned, 81 proposals have been given in principle approval till date. 18 have obtained final sanction from the committee, and 7 have received disbursements. So when we look at disbursement, that figure is still pretty small. It's a work in progress, as Jyoti said, and I agree that, you know, I know a lot of members in the team, and they're learning on the job as they're going around, because it is a very complex subject. As even Jyoti mentioned, that, you know, there are n number of permissions, and we have to understand these are stuck projects. These are the projects, any project which is needing this fund is basically stuck for one reason or the other. You know, it would inevitably mean that there has to be an existing lender in this project. Already the funds have dried up. There has to be some positive juice. That's why it's net worth positive. But at the same time, it won't have enough juice to make all lenders comfortable and happy. So there is a very evident situation that existing lenders may be forced to take some haircut as the journey continues, you know, which is where the main problem comes. The existing lenders are today jittery about grant of NOC to this. The biggest problem is not only complying with the municipal approvals or so on and so forth. They are challenges, but it is getting blocked at the level of existing lenders, because an existing lender, either the account is already NPA or it's already a stressed or a flat for being stressed, you know, and post COVID, I would think it's safe to assume 80-90% of those applicants would have been already flagged for a potential stress case. Existing lender has a dilemma. Once the account becomes NPA, existing lender will have to do provisioning in their balance sheet, which directly hits their bottom line. That bottom line impacts their share prices. Okay. They are answerable to their stakeholders, their board, about the performance of their balance sheet. You know, now, if they are going to make provisionings and they're going to take a hit, and at the same time, they have to cede the charge of the asset to Swami. And only once Swami would exit, then they get the asset back. You know, by that time, the cover might have depleted a lot more. Now, the question that, yes, Swami has agreed to share somewhere 5% of the cash flows, somewhere 15% of the cash flows. In some projects, that 5 or 15 may cover the interest of the existing lender. My assumption is that in most of the projects, it will not cover that, you know. So the existing lenders would have a challenge of doing, making their accounts NPA and ceding the control of the security. Now, existing lender's dilemma is that if I'm going to do a provision, take a hit, why should I rather not sit with the asset? At least I've got Sarafazi with me. I've got other enforcement tools. You know, I can do something about that. Because they're not getting pari passu charge with Swami in this. So the issue is not with the fund manager, which is SBI Cap Venture. It's with the mandate of the fund. Right. Now, the mandate of the fund either has to take the concerns of the existing lenders on record. And I'll add just two more points, and then, you know, I'll end on that. It is not the public sector banks who are more amenable for granting NOCs, because if we look at most of the lending, wholesale lending, as it's called, to construction, to developers, the developer financing were done by NBFCs and HFCs or AIF funds post 2012. You know, so 80% of that funding has come from NBFC, HFC, AIF segment. They are not very agreeable to give this NOC, you know, that is where the larger problem is coming. Okay. And secondly, if what could be the solution for something like this? One solution would be a pari passu charge, but to my mind, it's very unconventional. Senior secured lenders, when they come in any kind of a distress, they always have a superior charge. So it would be quite unconventional, and Jyoti Bhai would throw more light on this. I'm not a banker, you know, to have that knowledge, but that's my experience, that senior secured lenders would never probably agree to a pari passu. Now, solution exists that if RBI were to relent and provide a forbearance to the existing lenders in projects where Swami is funding and give them a ring fencing against NPA for, let's say, the tenure of Swami plus another 12 months, I think you will see a queue tomorrow morning outside SBI to give NOC. the main problem of what I have understood dealing with the fund for last 8-9 months on behalf of CREDAI lies there, that they are not getting cooperation from the existing lenders who have their own set of challenges. I leave it at that for now.
Yeah. Jyoti, pick it up from where Rohit has left off.
Fantastic, Rohit bhai. Yes,
I will ask you one question. Jyoti, yes, I'll just ask you one, there is one question here. Now, as Mr. Modi suggested or said that there are projects which are cash positive today, but if the entire construction is completed with the revenue that is coming in, after that, the lenders cannot be paid entire money. So the lenders might have to take the haircut. Now, if the lender knows this fact that not today, then tomorrow he will have to take the haircut. And then RBI must also be aware of this fact. Then why RBI will allow it that, boss, you should take the haircut right now today. Why should you wait it to take it tomorrow? Because that will affect the entire banking sector. So in that situation, RBI is also right, to my point, to my mind.
Prabhakarji, the only difference which could be there, no, that today, if let's say a resolution doesn't happen, no last mile happens, then what will happen to the project? It will get into NCLT. It will go under IBC. Normally, one has seen is that the haircuts are far more steeper under a resolution process. We have yet to see, you know, too many examples of successful real estate projects coming out of IBC. Whereas if the asset gets completed, the value addition in the asset will be far more than the distress value today. You know, everything on distress sells for 25 cents or 20 cents to a dollar. But once it's completed, then the asset value might be much more. Lenders, and I said that in some cases, this may be true. It may not apply to all the cases. Lenders may have to take a smaller haircut that day. They might be able to recover 50, 60, 70, 80% of their capital. Whereas under a distress or a liquidation, their recovery might be 20, 30%. You know, that is the only reason why it should be seen with a positive light than to say, okay, let's clean the slate today.
No, I understand, sir. But only thing is that it should have been ring-fenced from CBI and other authority also. Because this point, the CBI will not, a banker might understand it. Even if RBI give them certain guidelines, they might understand it. But they will fear it, ki, boss, tomorrow if investigation starts, I will end up into another situation. So that will be a very dire one. So that's my, anyway, please Jyotiji.
Yes. Sir, Prabhakar, sir, Rohit ji are absolutely bang on the points that you are mentioning. As the Rohit ji has already mentioned that it is the PSU bank which are far more amenable to this fund. The reason behind is that ki, all these, because in the PSU bank, if there is any stress in the account or they are not able to repay the loan, it is a system generated NPA that happens. When there is a system generated NPA, so then there is a different department that start dealing with the account. And then the case is already referred to NCLT or some sort of recovery proceedings has already started. And bank has, the important point to note is bank has started making provisioning for those loans as on date, as soon as the loan automatically as it happened. But while in the case of NBFCs and the AIFs, what happens is that in case if there is a stress in the account, wo log usko term loan 2 year, term loan 3, whatever, they will try to do some sort of a evergreening of the loan and they will not show that account as an NPA account. So they have not made any provisioning in their books of account as on date. So that is why to give the priority charge for existing NBFCs and for AIFs is difficult. But for any of the banks, if you have to go and tell them, ki, boss, now it is an NCLT referred cases, so you have already done 50% ka write-off aapka ho chuka. Or if it is a liquidation case, then 100% write-off you must have done on that. So we have to go and convince to the existing lender or to a PSU bank, ki, whatever is the amount of write-off that has happened, balance amount is far more enough than that, the whatever the juice which is enough, whatever the juice which is left in the project, it is much more than the amount which is then left over in the books of account of the PSU bank. But in the case of NBFC, it is difficult for us to convince because as you have rightly pointed out, ki, there is some sort of a haircut. Nahi toh project mein stress hi nahi hota na. If there is all the cash flows in the project would not have got into any stress. But the good thing that has happened last 2 weeks before when this Supreme Court order came about the rate of interest about the Noida authority, I suppose the lot of projects which were not getting sanctioned by the Swami Fund or by the existing lender also, there are 10-12 projects I have been made aware that those are now capable, or the existing lenders have started giving NOC because of the project becoming the viable as on date. So this is again the point that what the Rohit ji has mentioned, ki existing NBFCs were reluctant because they have not recognized those loans as bad in their books of account, and there is no provisioning being done till date.
So what is the solution? Why? Because this problem for NBFCs continues. So why will they give this, they will seed the first charge?
So they will seed the first charge only on those cases they are seeding the first charge wherever we can show them that there is an enough juice available in the project after the repayment of the Swami Fund which is there. In case if we cannot show them, then at the present moment they are not giving the priority charge.
Jab maan lijiye seed kar diya, to agle 6 mahina tak inko payment nahi aayega.
Sir,
inke account mein
Sir, NBFC can structure the loan in that way that they may not have to do it. But in case if they have to write off the amount, or what we have done it one or two other cases is that we have again given them the existing NBFCs, some other collateral or some other cash flows, which is not the part of this loan, just to request them, ki sir, aap is project mein mujhe priority charge kar dijiye. We have given them some other project or some other cash flow. So there are some NBFCs which are again hard bargaining again on that part also. When he knows that that there is a Swami fund which has come in, they can give the fund which is getting at 12%, or they are charging around 18% rate of interest. So it is a various sort of permutation combination which is going on in the market also. There are different NBFCs for same NBFCs. For different project and for different promoter, they are set taking some other stand, whatever, some different stand which is there. Another point, the last point which I wanted. It is not only the priority charge from the existing lender, which the Swami Fund is asking. He's also asking NOC from the existing lender will not move to litigation or to IBC also. So obviously, this is also they are again ye nahi keh rahe ki aap humko priority charge de dijiye. They are again saying ki sir kabhi bhi during till the time Swami fund is there, existing lender doesn't have any other right in terms of litigation also or in terms of IBC also, sir.
Nahin, buyer ja sakta hai, nahin ja sakta IBC mein.
Buyer ke liye to sir uske andar mein jo abhi jitne bhi adi, if the project is under NCLT, then the home buyer association ke saath milke resolution plan abhi jama hota aur usi ke andar ye Swami fund clear hota hai koi cheez ke liye. Aur in case if the home buyer association is been formed, then the home buyer association is also taken into confidence ki sir there will not be any penalties to the home buyer that will be paid. That again the home buyer association ke jo bhi representative hai, they have to give that in writing. That no penalties, because there might be some builder penalties because of the late delivery of the project and other things that can happen. So all these penalties will not be payable. That home buyer has to give that in writing.
Given
that is happening. Sorry. That is happening only under resolution planning.
That is only
That's only under resolution, not otherwise.
But otherwise, to Swami fund, this criteria is not there that buyer needs to give the undertaking that they will not go for the litigation or they will not go for the penalty charges.
Swami is, to my knowledge, Swami is not asking for this undertaking from the home buyers that they will not litigate.
Exactly.
Or they will not do that. Yeah. But Jyoti ji would know better.
I will just like to point out that in case if the, as the Rohit ji has pointed out, that the project has to be net worth positive. So we have to calculate what is the amount of cost need to be incurred. In that amount of cost need to be incurred, if we have taken into account the home buyer ka jo penal interest ka jo payment adhi maine include kar rakha, then definitely I will not go and ask that to the home buyer. In case in my financial planning or to give the positive cover, if I have not included that home buyer penalty, and actually while doing the DD, if they come out that there is a home buyer penalty that is getting there, at that point of time, I have to get an NOC from the home buyer. It is only depending upon what sort of financials that I am presenting to the Swami fund while getting the loan.
Okay.
Before we go on with the discussion, I'd like to stop here and tell our consumers, there's a very large body of home buyers who are joined in, and many of them are in stress projects. The fact is that these projects have not moved because of various reasons. One of the biggest reasons is that there is not enough capital to complete that project at this point of time, and projects have actually been held up. If you don't start that cycle of construction, you will not be able to recover the money, and it will sink deeper and deeper into debt. The other big thing is that why do you need this small amount infusion of funds? Why can't the existing lender do it? The thing is that you need a small infusion of funds as what is known as a seed capital. It starts the cycle of finance. Maybe tower one is constructed. There are 10 units which are which haven't been sold. Those get completed. Those get, one tower is finished. You move to the next. These can be put on the market. There's unsold land, unutilized land, which becomes part of how the project becomes cash positive. And with all this, what happens is that what they call this virtuous cycle starts, where the developer can construct, the consumers can get their projects, their units in staggered construction cycles. And that's how this entire thing resolves. The thing was that without this fund, there was no way that construction would have restarted across the country. Today's conversation is not about why the projects got stuck. We have done several shows. We will do many more shows around why projects got stuck. But today's is, how do they come unstuck? The 25,000 crore is something that the government of India mandated. The first 10,000 crores, I think, is from SBI. It's a 25,000 crore fund, alternate investment fund that is mandated by the government of India, which is being managed by SBI CAPS. And it will come to the developers. Developers apply for it. And this fund, if I'm not mistaken, it's the last in, first out, right? They come in, they put the money, they complete the project, they take their money out, and they go on. But for the existing lenders, there are many ifs and buts, and that is what we were discussing. For you as consumers, remember that you have been agitating for that penalty. Now, as I understand it, does the consumer have to forfeit that penalty?
Not necessarily. Not necessarily. But if the project is under insolvency, mm-hmm. and is already a resolution plan is being presented. Now, the presenter of the resolution plan depends if he has asked for penalties to be forfeited, or is he granting the penalty. Now, that's part of a resolution proposal where the home buyers have a lot of weightage and a voting to say whether they accept it or they don't accept it. I want to highlight here one thing. Mm-hmm. It was in news media just 5 days ago when the new board of Unitec Limited, which has been it's a central government appointed board, has presented or is probably presenting a resolution proposal to the Honorable Supreme Court, where they have said that no penalty will be paid to any home buyer, and neither they will be charging any home buyer for their defaults in payments. Because it has said that the foremost objective should be to deliver the homes to the home buyers and not let the cash flows leak in paying the penalties and things like that. Yeah. And I would like to use your platform to highlight this point, that while I fully empathize that, you know, the double whammy of EMI and rental has been pinching and all the home buyers whose projects are delayed, the eye should be on the price, which is that home. You know, if you have put, let's say, 70 lakh rupees for that home, now should you rather let that get completed by facilitating all this, or should you agitate for that 2 lakh penalty versus a 5 lakh penalty and let things not happen? As you said, the more it gets delayed, the more deeper it will keep falling into the abyss.
What we've noticed is that there are two types of buyers. In every project, there are two types of buyers. The ones who need their house and who are willing to do anything to get that house completed and restored to them. And the other lot, which has invested in projects with a hope that the prices would have gone up. 5 years, the prices have not gone up, and it makes more sense for them. I mean, it makes economic sense to demand your refund at 10% rather than MCLR rates, rather than ask for the house to be completed. Now, I think somewhere one more point I want to make. When you look at house pricing, the last 5 years, you've seen a really flat market. In some cases, 5 to 9%, we've seen prices come down. In select markets, it has gone down even further. But more or less, the markets have been under stress across the country. But Of late, and especially post-COVID, and this is something that we did a seminar yesterday in the Karnataka region, we find that there is more traction in the market. End users are there in the market. Therefore, if there are units that are being completed, there is a demand for housing. And there's a demand for, in Karnataka, it's 2 and 3 BHK. We're in the process of studying other markets as well. In a market where end users are very active and who want to pick up, clearly, as you complete projects, completed housing with zero risk of delay is what consumers are looking at. Will this bring a huge amount of completed units into the market?
Is that to me?
Yeah.
Do you mean that will Swami help in bringing a lot of completed projects?
Once you start the virtuous cycle,
yeah,
once the
absolutely.
Construction starts, that's when the projects, completed units start coming into the market,
yes.
Right?
Yes, absolutely. You're absolutely right that if the funding from Swami were allowed to flow freely into the projects which are meeting the eligibility criteria by all the stakeholders, which means existing lender, the promoter, the regulator, and the home buyers, we will see projects, a lot many more projects hitting the deck in a completed form in next 12 to 24 months time. Because also let's remember, Swami's one of the objective is to come into those projects which can be completed in the shortest possible time as well. So it's not putting its fund into project which will take 3 years to be completed, but the one which might take less than 12 months to be completed, where 70% of the work has already been done. So it will actually help in completing a lot of projects, bring a lot of ready to move in homes in the market.
If that happens, and if the markets are stabilizing, consumers, and I'm going to ask the consumer, I'm representing a consumer when I ask this because it's repeatedly asked. Why can't that consumer then wait till the entire project is complete? And if there still is cash in that project, why can't he demand his penalty? Should he's waited long enough, he's taken the double whammy. Why should the consumer now have to, because the lender was in the committee.
Yeah,
I knew that things were going wrong, but the consumer was not in any committee. He did not know things were going wrong. And
no, Jasri, he is allowed to do it. In fact, in Amrapali case, Supreme Court has said it that though the consumers will not be paid right now for their delayed payments, but they have the right to file case against the developer to get their money back, the damages get back. So in these cases also, though they will not get from the consolidated fund, but they have the right to file the case against the developer to get their money. Nobody is stopping him from that.
Not if they've written it off. And I'm challenging the clause of making the consumer sign off that I will not ask for penalty. I have taken the blow, but I will not ask for penalty because today...
That is NCLT.
That's only in NCLT. It's not happening otherwise.
NCLT, then he is giving that undertaking that I will not ask for that. But if it is not in NCLT, then the later date, he can go and ask for his damages. Isn't it, sir?
Yes. See, consumer has got a lot of legal recourse under consumer acts, under RERA, and generally under the law. So, and it will be completely unfair to tie the hands of the consumer who's already suffered for so long to say that you are not entitled.
Yeah.
A resolution plan is a voluntary acceptance of a plan in which the home buyer is actually a very important consequence of the COC. You know, so there it is their choice whether to accept or not, or they can dissent also to that. But in other situations, they're absolutely free to pursue their demand for the compensation for delay, etc. What the point that one was trying to make was that should that become a hurdle in accessing Swami, then what should be the bigger picture? Should I fight for my home for which I've already paid 90 lakhs out of 1 crore? Or should I fight for that 5 lakh which the builder is giving me out of 5 rupees per square foot or for MCLR plus 1%? You know, that's a trade-off which everybody has to make for themselves.
In fact, here I would like to address the consumers who are locked in and say, your first objective has to be to complete the project. Get that project completed, get that unit in hand. Today, if it is a stressed asset, it has not more than 30% of the worth, of its intrinsic worth. you get the project completed, it has 100% at least of its worth. Let's assume it hasn't appreciated, at least it would not have depreciated. If it's completed, there is a market for completed assets. You can exit the project even if you come in as an investor at that point of time. But if you get stuck on bargaining for the refund of your project or the penalty for your project, the project will never move forward. And this entire concept of Swami was, let me put some funds in, let me get the get it started. And when the last consumer gets his house, the last stuck consumer gets his house, that's when you can address the issues. And the positive thing is that what Rohit is saying, that consumers are not held back. The consumer can continue, but let the process of construction happen. Jyoti, help me understand, if this, let's take Rohit's case. He's applied, he's got his money. Now, take us through this, take the consumer through this entire process of how this will work. How does this concept work?
Like, suppose if the project is under NCLT or not under NCLT, let me take two examples and then I will complete that entire run-through cycle. The good thing about the Swami Fund, before even I start this discussion, let us understand how this Swami Fund actually gives the disbursement. Swami Fund will assume ki how much is the money required now to complete the project. And it will assume that there will not be any inflow into the project after this. So it will not assume any sale. It will also not assume that any of my existing customer is going to repay me anything. So it means the entire financial closure he wants is as on date before even he starts giving the first check or he starts giving the first amount as disbursement also. So this is what the Swami Fund mandate is, and Swami Fund is actually working towards that. Now Swami Fund is also looking at, this fund is also looking at some sort of the security cover, which Rohit has also mentioned, Rohit ji, ki 1.3 is the security cover which they minimum required, with principal plus interest and the amount jo bhi profit bach jata, this is the net worth positive thing. Now in that cost to be incurred, if I have taken into account ki so much of customer liabilities also has to be repaid before even I start the project, and if I have taken that customer liability, and with that customer liability my positive net worth is not coming or the project is not meeting the Swami criteria, then what I as a customer should do? Whether, because there are different stakeholders, there is one developer, there is a home buyer, there is an existing lender who are there. So there are three lender, because whatever the plan that the Swami Fund is approving, to all the three parties, there is a consent which is required. So now there is a dilemma before the home buyer, as Rohit ji has pointed out, that at that point of time, home buyer should be rational enough and see, sir, let us see that how the project can be completed first at this point of time. Once the project is completed, home buyer can always say that at least till the time the Swami Fund loan and interest is repaid, I will not ask for my penalty, because let the project get completed. Once the project gets completed and once the Swami Fund is repaid back, thereafter, if there is any surplus coming, then there are two contenders. One is the home buyer penal interest. The another contender is the existing lender, if there is any. So there is a comp. Now at that point of time, how much would be the distribution between the existing home buyer that rate of interest or the penalty or the existing lender? This is going to be clear out between these two parties at that point of time. If we can have the answer right now, it's better. If we can an answer later on, it's between both the parties to answer that. Regarding NCLT, since the case is under an NCLT and the home buyers are the part of the approving authority of this resolution plan, because in the entire scheme of things, home buyers are also taken as the financial creditor as per this IBC guideline. So they are part of that plan. So they have got absolute right with them whether they will agree to that plan or not agree to that plan. So if they have agreed, it is up to their wish list. If they have not agreed, it is their thing. But what Rohit ji was trying to point out as a humble request was that, ki sir, we need to look it from a broader picture. Ki sir, project pehle complete hona chahiye. Uske baad sir, 5 lakh versus ki aapko 3 lakh rupee interest ka to tab milega when also the builder is in a position to pay you that interest. So this is what the balance that needs.
Sir, ek cheez bataiye, jo aap cash positive ki baat karte hain. ये कैश पॉजिटिव नेट ऑफ एग्जिस्टिंग लेंडर्स पे आउट के बाद है या नो
उसका नहीं लेते हैं एज पर एज द स्वामी फंड कैश पॉजिटिव इज कंसर्न्ड ही इज ओनली टेकिंग इनटू अकाउंट टू कॉस्ट पैरामीटर की सर आज से प्रोजेक्ट कंप्लीट होने में कितना पैसा लगेगा वेर एवर द प्रोजेक्ट इज एज ऑन डेट हाउ मच मनी वुड बी रिक्वायर्ड टू कंप्लीट द प्रोजेक्ट एंड दैट टू टुवर्ड्स द कंस्ट्रक्शन कॉस्ट दे आर नॉट ट्राइंग टू पे एनीथिंग टुवर्ड्स द लैंड कॉस्ट ड्यूज ऑल्सो बट नाउ इन सम ऑफ द केसेस दे हैव अंडरस्टूड दैट विदाउट पेइंग द लैंड कॉस्ट ड्यूज द प्रोजेक्ट विल नॉट गेट कंप्लीटेड so now they have little bit bended on the rules and regulations they are saying that whatever is cost that will be required to complete the project that is the cost that they will take and then they will take on a most pessimistic approach that the sales value aap ek cheez maan lijiye if you have shown them ki sir maine 4000 mein maal becha to sir wo log 3200 rupaye ka sale value lenge so they will try to take around 25% of the discounted current sale prices so I'm not giving a thumb rule to it but yeah. this is what my practical experience is while dealing with them
customers inflow bhi to count karega
the customers inflow bhi wo log le lenge lekin uske andar bhi wo log that they will go and check and verify whether the customer will pay or anything so you can safely assume that around 50-60% of the customer inflows can only be taken into account and all the unsold inventory ki price approximately around whatever the price that you are selling little bit discount to that so okay. that is the price realization in the project aur jitna mujhe kharch karna in dono ke baad mere ko cash positive hona chahiye project ke andar
that's very correct approach
that's absolutely no. sir it is a sensible approach sir it's it sensible. Is as rohit ji ne jo bola sir it is one of the best parameterized form absolutely no ambiguity anywhere it is sir it is the problem with the existing the lender NOC and it is with the home buyer agreeing to the terms and condition it is not the problem of the fund yes Rohit ji you were saying something
I completely agree with you you know there was another very radical thought which can make the deployment of Swami fund literally on steroids kind of a thing you know if I were to use that today everywhere where Swami is going to step in safe to assume 99% of those projects would be having an existing lender who is under stress or nearing stress. If Swami can, instead of going by developer funding, can also become a partly like a refinance organ setup where it actually funds the existing lender. Let's say there's an existing lender, ABC. The ABC approaches Swami, says, look, I've got 11 projects which are meeting your criteria, they are under the stress. For these 11 projects, I require 500 crores. Okay. And I will administer this 500 crores because I am the best person. I've been with this promoter and the project for last 3 years. I know in and out. And I will put in the money. I will borrow from you. I'll put in the money and I'll monitor it. You and I go pari passu on that or on some such sort of a basis. You know, the deployment will become very fast. Instead of having a confrontation, you will become partners together. And the end objective being resolution of stuck projects will actually, you know, start becoming far more speedier. The entire due diligence, time, cost, all of that can get saved where you actually make the existing lender partner of the fund rather than right now, if I may say, some sort of a adversary, as in that I am last in, first out, so I get everything out and then you are not even in my calculation sheet of a net worth positive.
Sir, one thing, in this I am told that the project account will be managed by the Swami fund itself.
Yes, yes. So which is fair enough.
They will take control of the entire project, it seems then.
Which is most of the lenders are doing it anyways in the projects where there is a bit of a stress, where you know you send your bills, the lender releases the check or the funds from the escrow account system.
And contractor will be paid directly by the fund itself.
Yes, yes.
So they will not give fund to the developer. They will particularly manage the entire project and they will do all those mathematics.
They have all the PMC appointed for that project. All the project management consultant and the project account is also operated by the fund. I suppose as Rohit ji has pointed out that in maximum of these NBFCs funded the project also, if there is little bit of a stress also, they are going to take control over everything. Regarding the Rohit ji, whatever that the Rohit ji was saying that it is the NBFC we should approach. I suppose right now in this last 2 months, what I have seen with my practical experiences, that NBFCs has only approached Swami fund that I have funded out of 10 clients, that 2 or 3 clients, why don't you fund them? So in the recent case, last 1 month before, when we approached the Swami fund for one of our clients, the Swami Fund look at the list and said ki boss ye NBFC ne to mere ko ye project bataya hua hi nahi hai, to iska matlab aap pehle you speak to the NBFC whether they are going to give me the priority charge or not. So only for those project where NBFC has not directly approached the Swami Fund, there only now they are asking to get the priority charge letter. Because otherwise those NBFCs and AIFs, they have already speaking to the Swami Fund also, because they know the criteria. So whatever the project that they feel that they can seed the priority charge, so that list is there, or they are in speaking terms with each other right now.
Will RERA be applicable in this whole process? Once the Swami Fund comes in, what is the role of RERA here?
Rohit, if you can say, take that.
So RERA continues obviously to be the regulator for all consumer protection. Even in that case, RERA compliances will have to be made by the promoter. As it happens, all the RERA compliances, whether it's a 70-30 escrow mechanism, quarterly compliances, they all will have to be adhered to. There is no overlap, so to say. In that case, now the question comes that in the interim, if a home buyer goes to RERA and says, look, I'm an aggrieved party, would RERA award a penalty, would award a refund? That would actually depend upon the RERA's own discretion. They are fully entitled to do so. It's at their discretion how they want to look at it.
But once the Swami Fund comes in, the first attempt is to complete the project. No outflows will be there till the project is complete.
Towards the project expenses, towards the expenses which have been put into the business plan as approved by Swami.
So, regarding RERA, I would like to clarify that in case whatever the amendment that we have posted, like my project completion date and other thing, whatever the earlier date that I have posted into the RERA website, and now there is a new date which is coming up, so I would require amendment to that effect from the RERA. Now my project completion date, earlier I mentioned this, and now this is the project completion date, and this is how it need to be completed. So those amendment, whatever that I have proposed in the fund, so before release of that, those amendments from the RERA has to come in.
But it does not ensure that RERA will grant you all of that. Just
that
because
is correct. Lekin beggar RERA ke paisa nahi milega, Rohit ji.
Correct. You have to be RERA compliant completely in terms of all your, you have to tick all the boxes of RERA, otherwise you will not get the funding.
Say, Prabhakar ji, there is one more interesting thing which has come up regarding RERA. There are some states where some other name which is being told, like Hira and other things. So there again, this Swami Fund is not getting operated. So again, it is a center versus state issues. Because of those, also all the developer of those states are also getting affected because they have used the word RERA. Although we have gone and told to the Swami Fund, ki, sir, although I belong to a state where RERA is not applicable, but whatever the points that the RERA is telling us to comply with, I'm voluntarily complying with that. But are you going to give me the funding? That the fund mandate says that without RERA compliance. So you have to just know the word. It is the RERA RERA word which is there. It is not the, it is in the letter and spirit you have to follow.
This is wrong. This is very wrong.
Because any other state where there is not RERA is not applicable, or they are calling it by some other name. अरे किसी और नाम से उसको बोला जा रहा है उस स्टेट में, तो सर वो प्रोजेक्ट उस स्टेट के प्रोजेक्ट
सिर्फ एक स्वामी, वो सिर्फ एक स्टेट में है,
वेस्ट बंगाल,
वी ऑल बिलोंग टू प्रभाकर सर, तो
इट वाज क्रिएटेड एज अ नेशनल लॉ, इट वाज सपोज्ड टू बी प्रोटेक्टिंग कंज्यूमर्स अक्रॉस द कंट्री, एंड इफ एवरी स्टेट डिसाइड्स टू टेक इट इन इट्स ओन हैंड्स एंड से आई ट्वीक इट, देयर वाज सम अमाउंट ऑफ ट्वीकिंग दैट वाज पॉसिबल, बट यू कांट allow every state to redefine the law, because it's not a national law, and a lot of thought went into RERA. So honestly, I would say that it does require the backing of all across party lines. But there is another thing that I would like to raise, Rohit, and this is something that many people have written here in our the comment box. Suppose you have 12 projects that are stuck. If you're developer A, you have 12 projects that are stuck, and you choose to pick up the last project and say that this is the one that I will put in Swami. But there are 11 other previous projects where the consumers are saying that even we are stuck, It's the same developer, but developer A does not even take it there. And in many cases, we have noticed, and this has come as a complaint from the consumers, the developer says, why don't you write off all penalties? Then I will take the project to Swami. If there's going to be a tussle between you and me, I will not take the project to Swami. Now, this is an issue with many consumers. I thought it's good to have your
Actually, there is an upper cap to how much RERA would fund to a single project or to a single developer.
Yeah.
The number, I think, Jyoti, would be it better placed than
400 and 800.
Yeah. So only 400 crores can go to a single project and 800 to a given
group.
So,
Is it taken into consideration that that developer has, let's assume, 12 projects and one project he's taken, let's assume, 400 crore to complete that project? What happens to the remaining projects?
No, it's a project specific, actually. It's a resolution at a project level.
And the consumers would do well to settle it with their developer, because ultimately the developer has to apply to Swami.
Look, what you are saying, I mean, it is sort of, you know, akin to a kind of a coercive negotiation kind of a thing, you know, where the developer is probably pressurizing, you know, for home buyers to come to a certain point. As I said, you know, these are contractual issues. It will have to be settled between the two parties and to seeing that which side of the bread is actually buttered, you know, to be honest.
And here, what Jyoti was telling us, that if it is the lender who goes, the NBFC who goes and says that I have 11 funds, I think that NBFC is not looking at project A or project B and compensation one and compensation two. The lender is looking at completion of projects, getting their money out and exiting the projects. So there, that.
There also, sir, there are three restrictions with the internal restrictions unofficially. One is the 400, 800 crores restriction. Again, there is a restriction on the amount of money which any city can also get. But there is an entire corpus that how much that Delhi NCR will get, how much Bombay market will get, how much Pune market will get. So they have also put in some sort of a market size. They have also put in this city-wise restrictions are also there. So it has to comply with everything, because they have to see that there is an equitable distribution of fund all across India and all across developers and everything. But I suppose in case if the fund performance is up to the mark, then this 25,000 crore fund, definitely this is too small a fund sizes given the amount of complexities that we have and the amount that the market requires right now. But in case if this fund performance is up to the mark, I suppose there are many onto the fences which are there, which are looking at the fund performance and everything. There will be huge FIIs interest that will come up and they will start funding this sort of things, which is there.
Can groups of home buyers also apply to Swami?
They can also apply, sir. But they have to, if they are applying, then there is a change in the developer clause also. They have to say that which developer they are coming in, and then the existing right of the developer, it is better that they apply through the NCLT route, through the resolution plan. In case if the home buyer need to apply, I'm just giving an escape route that this is a better way of applying, because that take care of entire litigation problem and issues.
Prabhakar, you want to ask something? That's a very complicated message. I'm trying to get my head around it before I ask you guys.
Basically, now in this entire story, now problem is this, that 25,000 crore, as you are saying, is a very small amount. And basically, time is running out. And another thing, what I would like to say is that this is not the place where bankers should try to learn. In fact, are the experiment. Here is the place where you just get going. Because if the project get delayed by another 6 months or 1 hour, 1 year, that project is going to get killed completely. So now if the funds are really wants to come, so why are they not coming right now? On that day, SBI also saying that, okay, they will also try to create a fund. SDFC is also working on a fund. But none of these funds are coming. So what is basically creating problem? Where is the problem? Why are they not coming in?
Sir, I give you 2-3 examples of why the IBCs and other things. So this will also give you the problem of stress cases in India. I'm not talking about the stress cases in the real estate is concerned. I will give you the problem of the stress cases in particular. Like in IBC, if you talk about say Prabhakar ji, you will see that there is a strict timeline. Ki sir, 90 din mein itna hona hai, 270 days mein hona hai. But look at how the timelines. We are handling around 28 cases in IBC. In out of 28 cases, we have found a resolution plan or we have found an investor in at least around 18 cases. Out of these 18 cases, the case took approximately around 1.5 years, or it took around 9 months even to decide by the NCLT and with the authority. So in the meantime, the investor went away. So whatever the timeline that we are talking about, like in terms of the stress asset, the stress fund also, sir, amount of approvals which is required, amount of process, now you could understand ki kitni jagah ki approvals are required to be in place. Because everywhere the regulations or the plan that we have submitted earlier, now they need to be resubmitted, and again I need to get a fresh approval on everything. Whatever the approval, whether it is a RERA approval, whether whatever the pollution approval, there are small, so many approvals which are required, sir. While if I've say taken the land on lease, then all the leasehold records, everything has to be again set right in order. If the project is stalled, it means there are home buyer issue. There are some home buyer which has gone to consumer court. There are some home buyer which has gone to NCLT. There are some home buyer which has gone to some of the court cases. So there are different home buyers also scared across everywhere.
So before going to Swami, you will have to reconcile this.
You have to reconcile with everything, sir. Sare problem ka the solution nahi hoga, tab tak to project start nahi hoga. Tab tak you will not get the Swami fund disbursement, Prabhakar ji. It is not like that. You have to resolve each and every issues of the project.
That also brings a problem of, you know, what comes first, the chicken or the egg, because absolutely you require right funds to solve some of these problems. Now you don't have fund to solve the problem. You can't solve the problem. You can't get the fund.
So Rohit is absolutely correct.
Therefore, I think the question that I was trying to get my head around, where consumers are saying that if we have to take back, why not the builder be advised to settle the compensation and interest? You can't settle, and this is something that I want to put. We have studied hundreds of thousands of cases, and between Prabhakar and I, we have done a million shows like this, where we've tried to figure out whether this can be done. If the compensation is paid out as NCDRC is ordering refunds, the RERAs have ordered refunds. If you give refunds and if you settle compensations before the project is complete, remember the net worth of that project is only 30%.
Yeah, it's like throwing baby with the bathwater. If they will keep, it's like throwing baby with the bathwater. Keep harping on that. There's
so
no point.
Consumer needs to understand, no matter what you entered as an investor or an end user, if you don't let that project get completed today, it's already delayed. Everybody has lost money. The developer, the lender, the consumer has lost money. At least let that project be completed so that from 30%, its net value becomes 100%. From there, there is RERA, there is NCDRC, there is NCLT. You can approach whichever forum you like and ask for your refunds. But let the projects get complete. Let stuck projects get completed. If you don't do that, the entire economy is going to hinge on this. The back sector, the economy is going to hinge on, can our real estate projects be complete? Which is why we spend so much time.
Also, you see, let's say because of this standoff, another 12 months get lost. So 12 months of rent that you have paid is down the drain. Pre-EMI interest that you have paid could have been the EMI if the project was ready. That's down the drain. And you have added 12 months ka notional delay penalty on your list. So it is, as Prabhakar has also been saying, Naki, the delay is going to kill it actually.
Exactly. That's what
delay from any quarter is just going to kill it. It will be impossible to revive many things after a point of time.
1 year delay means 15% cost escalation. As simple as that. And that is huge.
And I'm going to take this question, Mukesh Kamboj, because you're asking this question 10 times. I'm going to take this and post it to Jyoti, and just once, because I believe that we have tried to, what he's saying is that he is being arm twisted. His group of buyers is being arm twisted by the developer. Withdraw, then I'll apply for Swami. Right now, his thing is, can home buyers apply for Swami fund when the builder is adamant that I will not you take away the compensation clause, only then will I apply. And he's saying that, Jyoti, your answer is not consistent with the answer by the CEO of Swami Fund regarding litigation for compensation by buyers. Do explain this.
I will just explain it to you.
Yeah.
In case if the home buyer wants to take over the project, I suppose this is the question, the gist of the question is, how can home buyer take over the project?
I don't think he even wants to take over the project. He just wants that the they don't want to write off the compensation even after the project is complete.
Sure, and that depends upon the, Jayashree ma'am, that depends upon the financials of the project. We cannot answer it on a general platform. In case if the financials of the project is good enough to sustain that, then definitely we can take into account. In case if the financials of the project are not good enough at the start of the project itself, then it will not meet the Swami Fund criteria, because if you include the penal interest,
yeah,
and if you give the financials to the Swami Fund, yeah, in case if it is meeting the criteria of the Swami Fund financials, then it's all right, you should go ahead and do it. Because our first chance, because as Prabhakar ji has also told and Rohit ji, we are all harping on the point that let's first complete the project.
No, Jyoti ji, here the issue is a bit different. What is happening here, that project has sufficient money. It can pay the delay charges also. But he is arm twisting the buyer to accept the clause right now, voluntarily, that they will not ask for the delay payment. Only then he will try to complete the project. Otherwise, he will not complete the project.
Won't even take it to Swami.
I will not go to Swami.
Sir Rohit ji, I suppose it is a builder issue. It is not a financial.
It's not a financial issue for sure.
If
let's say this is an arm twisting, so to say, that you are basically telling the home buyers to abrogate their rights. Then only you will actually apply for that funding. I'm assuming in that case the project would already be stressed and stuck. Homebuyer should go to NCLT and take the product into IBC.
Correct.
In fact, is the best way out. If you are in a face-off with your developer, you can't see eye to eye with the developer, and there is a chance of the project finishing, then I think the best thing for you is to go to NCLT and
take over the project.
Because, you know, Jayashree, you mentioned in the earlier part of the conversation that there are two types of buyers. You know, there's one which wants home at any cost, and the other who was basically a financial investor. And because the rates have not really gone up in 5 years, and in most of the cases probably have come down in absolute terms also, is more keen to ensure that there is a financial compensation available. You know, now it will be among the home buyers to see what is right for them and to protect their own interest. You know, because I would presume in most of the projects, the majority would be wanting the home, but there would still be a segment which would be more keen on financial compensation. They're not concerned whether the delivery can happen after 3 years also, because markets are the way they are right now. That's where the home buyers will have to exercise their own prudence to see what's good for them.
I'll actually conclude with what Justice Rohinton Nariman said in that Pioneer Urban judgment. He said that had the market been functioning well, and if the price of the completed unit was going to be significantly higher than what you entered it at, you would not ask for compensation. Today, we are in a stress situation. If the market is stressed and you're trying to squeeze money out of the system because it satisfies your financial greed, that is something that the system is not allowing. But for people like Mukesh Kamboj, who says that I have receivables of 130 crore and the required funds for completion is 60 crore as per the builder, can we home buyers apply to the Swami Fund? Maybe they can, right? They can walk up to the Swami and try Swami. If it doesn't work, go to NCLT. The consumer is not on the back foot today. The consumer is being heard in every forum. It's just that, remember, that ultimately what every person on this session has been saying, get the projects completed. It is in everybody's best interest. And even the Swami Fund is so that projects can be completed. And that's where I'm going to close this show. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thanks.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, Prabhakar. Thanks, Jayashree. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Wish you all the best.
Bye, Jayashree.
Bye.
Bye.